ESL Cloud Kingdom it is, and we have two very good players here getting ready to battle it out in the final best of one round of the qualifiers here today. And let's see, we're going right into it when everybody's loading up, of course. Are you ready, OD?
Yes, I'm fully loaded.
Very nice, me too.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the fourth round of the second qualifier of the GSL tournament.
GSL
This,
even.
oh, you know, I was just thinking about the future. No, it's the DSEL, even better. And at the top, we have Druids Kral, the Zerg player.
No, actually not. We have Druid Skrull spawning as the orange
Oh,
Protoss here in the
oh
bottom.
man.
So this introduction could have gone better, but you know, as a caster, sometimes you just need to go with what your mouth just said. You have no clue, but you have to say it anyway. So no problem at all. We know what it's like. But it is the Zerg player Shaggy here from Belgium
Yes.
spawning in the top. How are you, OD? Are you doing okay?
Well, it's getting late. No, it's not.
All
Okay,
right.
but yeah, I messed up with the GSL and then I messed up again, but
Not a problem, man. And we all
let's
like
see
to
what's
watch the
going to happen.
GSL anyway. But this is not the GSL, no, this is the Dutch StarCraft League, so it's a bit closer to home. And we have Kromman here getting ready to block the natural. Well, actually, Shaggy is going for a spawning pool first. Of course, nothing uncommon against a Protoss player, although, of course, we're kind of used to Dax's play style, who just likes to go for quick three hacks.
Okay, and let's see. Kral is going to go Forge first, but I think he could have been greedier in this case. Don't you think?
You mean go Nexus first?
Yes.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's just a little bit safer to do it this way, of course. Yeah, maybe he could get away with it. I'm not sure though. It all depends on Shaggy, and the Zerg are surprisingly
Oh
agile
wow!
just in the
We
front.
wanted to. Can he deny it again? Oh,
Oh, and he
very well done by Carl. And he's
actually, and
so.
this is, you know, delaying it quite a bit, but this distance looks large enough that Shaggy will finally get it down. There it is, but it's of course in the wrong position. And actually, will we see a double expand?
I believe so. Yes, we do.
All right, but Kralman immediately knows about it and is falling off behind this forge expand. So yes, now with this opening with two hatches, definitely you could have gone grittier, but well, you don't really know that. And it's quite nice, even though the pool first, he managed to block the natural hatch here for quite a while.
Yeah, so actually, maybe, what is it, Kral of Kroll?
I think Kralman. His name is Kralman, but he is now Druid's Kral.
Kral, okay, yeah. Maybe he chooses for an attack quite early. Maybe he follows this up with four gates. Or no.
Well, he actually could, but you
No,
don't see
of
that
course,
very
first the
often.
cyber at the core and then the four gate. And then put him some pressure because I got the feeling Shaggy's quite late.
Yeah, he's a bit delayed and he doesn't have any speed going yet. But well, yeah, I'm not quite sure if I would like to see a four gate from this point. I much rather see him go something with Stargate perhaps. Or just, you know, maybe even faking the immortal sentry push and then taking a third instead.
Yeah,
I've seen that quite a bit. It's nice.
But you know, the problem with faking is that your opponent has to fall for it.
Yeah, that's always true, definitely.
Because I tried it sometimes on the ladder, but nobody's falling for it at my skill level.
You were faking the Immortal Sentry all in that
sense. No, I was not faking the Immortal Sentry, something else.
Faking a bunker rush, maybe.
But yeah, then... empty bunker, and then you go with an empty bunker to the natural of the Zerg, and then you arrive and your bunker's up, and you see no reaction of the Zerg player, just nothing. Never happened to you?
Not recently, no. Okay. But let's see, third guy's going down, fourth guy's actually going down, so. If he really intends to mine all this gas, then well, we are either going to see a fake or an actual push of sorts.
Yes, he's quite heavy on the gas, and it looks like yeah, it's quite the same build as we saw. I forgot his name again.
Kamina? No, that was a Zerg
player. The other guy. Yeah. Never mind. I'm really messing this matchup with my casting, but
I think you are referring to Poseidon. But
it's that guy. Yes.
I actually look at this wall off here from Kral. Very nice. He wanted to get those gateways anyway, so that's quite good. And actually, plus one is going to finish up. It was quite early. Plus one, four in gas. Immortals being well, not Chrono Boosted right now because there's an observer being made, but. Yeah, I do feel. Oh, look at that Baneling busting action here.
There's only one slight problem with that wall off there at the ramp. Because if Shaggy is coming quick, and Kral is using the force fields wrong,
The question right now is, are there enough force fields and can Kralman use them exactly on time? He needs to respond immediately and...
What?
What?
He's using like all his Balings.
Oh, and the force fields are perfect. But they need to be repeated though, and actually the two gateways are coming down to complete the wall off once again. Now this is a full wall.
This is what I meant, because now he's got a problem, because he's losing the gateways in the pilots right now. He cannot defend them. Yeah, well seen by Shaggy.
And actually more Banelings coming in, but they do manage to take out the Forge, which is a huge problem, of course. No more Photon Cannons, and the pylon goes down, and yes, you are right, this gateway is going down without much of a fight. Actually, there's an Immortal rallied here, somewhere it shouldn't go.
Oh, this is not what Kral wants.
Banelings get in, and there are no more force fields left. The Banelings explode again and again, but actually these Immortals are getting quite a number of kills, but one goes down, and there's one left.
Oh, he saved the Sentries. Phew.
And actually, there's 22 more Lings coming, but I do feel that if Kralman gets his wall up right now, gets a couple of Sentries, he might be able to hold this off again, and then, of course, Shaggy will be in big trouble.
I just wanted to say he needs cannons, and immediately he adds two of them. So, but man, Shaggy throw a lot of Banelings on those structures of Kral, and I haven't seen
those yet. Were some absurd Baneling busts. Of course, layers going down. Will we see more Banelings? No. Not quite yet. Actually, another free pylon here. And oh, there's a Colossus out, and that's actually a very, very big boon for Kral here. That is definitely going to save something today. And now Shaggy is the one who needs to think up a transition fast. Look at this, the creep hasn't even been joined between the second and the third. And there's just Lynx here, and that's a major, major problem here. The Roach Warrior is going down, the Spire is going down.
Oh, I like
he has
that.
Quite a lot of gas, but so he could have a lot of mutas, but it will take a while to get up. And Kralman, in the meantime, killing his own warp gates just to be able to get out of his base.
Yes, I like the fact he's choosing for a Spire right here, because there's only
almost no Stalkers. Yeah, that's...
yes. So Mutalis can do a lot right now. So let's see, if he... He's choosing now for heavy Mutalisks. Oh, and look at this.
Yeah, I quite like this because it's, you know, it's a delayed tactic from Shaggy here. And you see a lot of players always forget about this, but it's actually quite good. Because it will take a lot of time.
And it takes a minute before the creep is gone. It takes a minute. And does Kral knows about the Spire. Let's see, an observer's flying in his base. An observer is flying in the base of Shaggy.
Oh, but he actually hasn't seen it yet.
He has not seen it yet.
No, and actually the observer is going out of the base again.
Oh boy.
Oh dear. And there's actually now 16 Mutalisks being built. This is quite a heavy play here. Needs to win with these Mutalisks, but there are no Stalkers out whatsoever.
Oh boy.
He really needs to see them coming, and he is spotting the fourth going down, which is quite nice, but oh dear.
I think Kral is overconfident right now. I think he knows that he knows what's up, but he doesn't.
Might actually be the case, and here all the Mutalisks are flying out of sight of Kralman to his forces here, and these will not stand up against this amount of Mutas. Look at that. What a transition here from Shaggy, remaining aggressive, and oh, those four Colossi. Oh man, that's going to be rough, and now he sees it immediately, Guardian Shields going up, but what can he do about this? And the sentries get targeted down. Oh no.
Oh, this is horrible. This is very horrible for Kral right here, what we see. Man, FK, he's going to pull back to the cannons, and Temple Archives is almost done, but when he is warping in High Templars, he doesn't have Storm.
And he's trying to warp in all the Stalkers that he can. Of course, the Stalkers are growing in number, but the damage has been done. Four Colossi have been taken, and there's still no third base for Kral here. Well, as actually Shaggy is transferring drones to his fourth base. What a play from this Belgian player here. Very, very, very nicely executed. And he's back in control of this game. Of course, there's no blink either for these Stalkers, so really, really caught off guard, and still a Colossus is building.
Yes, and let's see what's going to be follow-up of Shaggy, because if Kral is holding this off, there's going to be he's going to be for more Mutalisks. Oh, and
GG.
This is so cool. There's GG, some Zerglings were also streaming in, and Kral...
Yes.
Has been defeated.
Zerglings in his main, Mutas over his entire army with no units left to shoot up. That's a good time to GG. He was just completely caught off guard by that. And it was really a shame because he held off that attack well enough. I mean, it wasn't perfect, but it was good. It was a hard battle. And he just was caught completely off guard by that muted switch from Shaggy there. Very nicely done from our Belgian player here. Very nice. Even taking his fourth base with all this. But congratulations to him.
Yes, well done.